Hi, I'm Dr. Jim.
And I'm Dr. Janine.
And today we're going to be talking about something that you and everybody else needs, and you probably don't even know they exist. And people are often asking, you know, okay, what is an SPM? It's a specialized pro-resolving mediator. Now, resolve and mediator kind of tells it all right there.
Right.
It resolves inflammation and mediates healing.
You know, it is not like your regular, just something that helps inflammation.
No.
You know, there are so many things out there that help inflammation in the natural world. But the SPMs don't only help inflammation, it actually helps the body resolve the problem.
Right. You know, a lot of compounds, and I know people are saying, well, you know, I'm taking the curcumins from turmeric or something, and they are good anti-inflammatories,
yep.
And a lot of other products are too, no doubt. They stop the heavy inflammatory process like the interleukin 6s and so on and so forth. So they cause a lot of the problems with inflammation, but they can't do this process of creating or starting the healing process. That's the resolvins. That's what they got where they got their name. Some of these compounds they call resolvins, maricins, and so on. And they all, protectins even. And because of what they do, because they really do resolve inflammation, they protect the body or protect things from inflammation, and they actually set in motion the healing process.
Yeah, your body can make SPMs. They're that important that your body makes them. But as just about everything else, as you age, they get less effective. Or if there's a health issue going on, sometimes you're not able to make the SPMs the way you should. And a lot of people can't make the SPMs because they don't have adequate amounts of omega-3 in their body in order to make SPMs.
I was going to say the diet has a big
influence. Right, the diet's a big part because if you don't have what the body needs to make it, they're not going to make it. SPMs have not been out that long. They're actually pretty new in the supplement world.
Right. Now, they've been in our body. They've been around forever, but we didn't know about them. That's the key. Science has just started really learning about these compounds, and there's a whole family of them, but they've just started learning about these compounds 10, 15 years ago, and it's been a very slow process to bring it out. Currently, if you go to PubMed, do a search for SPMs or specialized pro-resolving mediators, oh my God.
But when you start looking at the research ranges from just about everything. Of course, all disease starts with inflammation.
I mean, that's been told forever.
When all disease starts with inflammation, all diseases can be helped by stopping the inflammation.
Exactly.
There's a lot of research coming out, even on cancer, on SPMs, because that's what you start with, is a lot of inflammation.
Yeah.
And cells not working properly. And if the body can actually make the cells work better and resolve the problems, maybe you wouldn't produce cancer cells.
Right.
So it talks about that. When COVID came out, there was stuff about scar tissue and the lungs being helped and resolved from SPMs. You see endometriosis, female issues, anything that's inflammation.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so we see so many people out there with increased markers on lab work. They're actually increased inflammation markers. And there's never been a product that we have used that works better than SPM at lowering those markers.
Yeah, that's true. Mm-hmm. It's true. We'll talk a lot more about that as we go through this. But, you know, I think, well, right now you're probably thinking, well, gee, I could just take some ibuprofen. That gets rid of inflammation too, doesn't it? Let's talk a little bit about inflammation. You know, there's actually two, if you will, parts to this inflammatory process. COX-1 or cyclooxygenase 1 and cyclooxygenase 2. We shorten it by, say, COX-1, COX-2. Now, COX-1 is when, I think you sprain your ankle. It gets red, it swells, it does all that. Hey, COX-1 is rampant right there. Now, as that process takes over and gets the things under control, and we got to start healing. Okay, that's when COX-2 comes in. One of the problems we've had with your typical your NSAIDs or anti-inflammatory medications for years is they suppress both COX-1 and COX-2. Now, suppressing COX-1, okay, that could be beneficial. Suppressing COX-2, you don't heal as well. That's not a good thing. And that's right. Where something like this SPM comes in, because it will actually enhance that COX-2 cycle and finish the healing process. Nothing else in the medications can do that. Even something like, and I know probably if you're some of the intelligent people out there, probably say, oh, gee, I've read about Celebrex. Yes, Celebrex can suppress just the COX-1, but it also gets some of the cytokines and so on that actually are very protective. Remember the protectins, very protective of our cardiovascular system. That's why they can't use it long term, because it can cause cardiovascular side effects.
Right. And the SPMs definitely have really good research on helping cardiovascular risk.
Oh, great.
They show that it helps the endothelial lining. It actually helps repair some of the parts in the cardiac area that actually nothing else does.
That's true.
So the SPMs is something that everyone really kind of needs to take a look at. Even if you don't have a problem, it's very protective. We've had people that over the years, rheumatoid arthritis, we've had fibromyalgia. A lot of times those are really hard and people have a lot of pain.
Right.
Can't believe how much better they feel when they actually add SPMs. Now, it doesn't work in an instant. So if you add it and in a day or two, you don't feel anything, that's actually pretty normal. It might take a month or two to get to full effect. So we do tell people, give SPMs a little time to work. But once they do work, you'll see a giant difference in how you feel.
When we first became available and they learned how to take an omega-3 and kind of do what our liver does, because our liver makes most of this stuff, pretty complicated. But what they found was some enzymes that they could use to actually make the EPA, DHA that's in fish oil or omega-3s actually turn into these pro-resolvins, protectins,
right,
and maricins. Okay, so they've learned how to make that in the lab, if you will. And now we've got it commercially available. So, yes, you still need to eat your omega-3s.
Right. You still can take omega-3s and you can take them together.
Yeah.
But when we do our omega check, which omega check looks at the omega-3 status in your body, people that are on SPMs have a much higher and better status when they've added SPM to their omega-3. So SPMs do play a big role.
As you probably, if you've watched any of our videos, you realize that we rely heavily on lab work to tell us, are we doing something right or wrong, right? If it's making a progress report, you know, that makes good, okay, that's great. So we watch thousands and thousands of lab works, and we've dealt with that many. And what we've seen was people that take the SPMs, even though they weren't really taking a lot of the other omega-3s, their omega check, which looks at your omega-3s, actually improved dramatically.
Right, it did. And the inflammation markers, nothing has affected the inflammation markers over the years the way I've seen SPM affected.
No.
Because we didn't have SPM years ago. So we used all kind of other things. Nothing has affected the lab work more than SPMs. Now, our SPM is actually called SPM Select.
Mm-hmm.
And we have both a 60 and a 120. If somebody doesn't have much of a problem and they're doing it preventatively, two a day might be adequate amounts.
It would give you a big start.
But if somebody has a problem, we do recommend four a day. So SPM is something that everybody can add to their regimen of supplements, and it is very, very good for overall health and maybe very preventative.
We talk about it preventatively a lot because people will say, a matter of fact, I had somebody just this past week and explained it, a little bit of this, similar to this. And they said, well, should I take the omega-3 or the SPM? I said, honestly, both would be fine. But if you're just going to pick one, I'd go with the SPM.
Yeah, because the SPM actually still has some omega-3 left in it. That's one that you do get a little bit of omega-3 when you take SPM. But when you take omega-3, you don't get SPM. So we have a lot of people take both. But if I was going to pick one, I'm with you. I would pick SPM.
I would say, okay, if I have one thing I could take, be the SPM. No doubt about it. Because it'll actually give you some extra omega-3s that your body can use for the DPA, DHA, and all that stuff. It can actually take that and make some of the other compounds that it needs. But having those resolvins, having those maricins and all that in that SPM family, that's huge. Yeah, and especially, here's one group, and I deal with a lot of, for some reason, I seem to wind up dealing with a lot of the people that have cardiovascular issues. And that's one of the first things I'm going to recommend for them is SPMs.
Yes.
I think it's that important. If you've got a cardiovascular history of any kind, you definitely need SPMs.
You definitely. SPM and our NATO Advantage. That's the
two things we go to for
cardiovascular. Yep.
Right. No doubt about it. No doubt about it. Hmm. Okay. So hopefully we've covered some information for you here today. Maybe you learned a little bit about SPMs.
Mm-hmm.
And you can always give us a call. We'll be glad to answer any questions that you may have about those compounds or anything else for your health. Thank you again for joining us and appreciate you watching this video.